I och med migrantkrisen har vardagen förändrats för många greker. Grekland var tidigare känt som ett av de säkraste länderna i Europa. Apixlat pratade med vanliga greker för att förstå hur krisen påverkade deras liv. Ankomsten av stora mängder migranter har vänt upp och ner på livet i städer och byar längs den grekiska gränsen mot Makedonien. Grekisk TV är full av intervjuer med förtvivlade lokala invånare.
Βοηθήσαμε. Ανοίξαμε την αγκαλιά μας και τα σπίτια μας στους πρόσφυγες και τους μετανάστες της Ιδωμένης. Όμως τώρα η κατάσταση είναι πλέον ανεξέλεγκτη, μας λένε.
Δεν μας υπολογίζουν καθόλου. Καθόλου μα καθόλου.
Έχει κλοπές, έχει διαρρήξεις. Έχει...
Πάρα πολλές, πάρα πολλές. Ό,τι μπορούσαμε τους δώσαμε. Και εμείς τι είμαστε, αγρότες είμαστε. Κάνουν κακό, σπάνουν. Είναι σαν εκδίκηση.
Σοκαρισμένη καταγγέλει πως ένας μετανάστης την απείλησε με μαχαίρι όταν του ζήτησε το λόγο γιατί μπήκε μέσα στο σπίτι της στην προσπάθειά του να διαφύγει μετά το πλιάτσικο που είχε διαπράξει στην αποθήκη με τα τρόφιμα του ΟΗΕ.
Δεν ντρέπεστε βρε γαϊδούρια, λέω. Ντροπή σας είναι αυτό, λέω, που κάνετε, λέω. Τι είναι αυτό, λέω. Σας λυπούμαστε, λέω, και εσείς τι κάνετε, λέω. Βγάζει ένα μαχαίρι και με λέει, με κάνει.
Vi reste till gränsstaden Idomeni och det tog inte lång tid innan vi bevittnade de svårigheter som byborna numera måste leva med varje dag. Här på videon är unga migranter i tonåren från Syrien i fart med att stjäla frukt från en trädgård och vandalisera en trailer. Allt detta medan de äldre greker som äger trädgården ser på och reagerar, men det verkar inte stoppa förövarna. Storstäder, öar och regioner längs gränsen är värst drabbade av den försämrade säkerheten till följd av migrantkrisen. Men det vore en underdrift att säga att allt är som det en gång var utanför de här områdena. På motorvägar på väg till Idomeni, långt före gränsen, passerade vi flera bensinmackar som tagits över av migranter. De hade förvandlats till spontana migrantläger där hundratals människor bor i tält. I privata samtal vittnar anställda på mackarna om en arbetsmiljö som är fylld av bråk, hot och stölder. Myndigheterna som inte längre har kontroll över situationen försöker anvisa vissa platser för migranter, som till exempel den här olympiska terminalen på Atens gamla flygplats. Där bor numera flera tusen migranter. Atens centrala delar kring torgen Victoria och Omonia var en gång trygga och säkra. De har nu förvandlats till farliga migrantgetton med mycket kriminalitet. Atenborna avråder från att åka dit till och med på dagtid på grund av risken att bli rånad eller misshandlad. Vi pratade med några greker som trots allt bor kvar i området.
How do you feel about living this close to Italy?
To be honest, I don't hang out here a lot. I'm very afraid. I mean, I had a lot of bad experiences here. I mean, they stole my money many times, and even my sister, they tried to rape her. I mean, let's be honest, it's very dangerous. Hmm. Yes. Two blocks away. 80 guys approached her, they made a circle around her, and they stole her bag, and then someone pulled her head and slapped her twice. But you know, she was very lucky. She shouted very, very loud, and a policeman approached them and stopped the whole scene. And they took them to the police station. But 3 days later, they liberated them because they said they are refugees and refugees can't go to prison. None of them were Syrian. They were all from Iraq and. Iraq and Iran.
Do you know if these people are they still here? Have you seen them afterwards?
Yes, of course, they are in the square. But we shoot them and maybe in 8 months there'll be a court for them.
But nothing happens when you report it?
No, nothing. No.
Is this common that girls get assaulted?
Yes, and the police never said anything. The media, they want to hide it. They don't want.
In how do they want to hide it?
They don't show the news to the people. I mean, they don't want to show. Maybe we can find just in some Greek newspapers, but that's it.
People have told us that it's very unsafe here in the night time. You shouldn't be here at all.
I mean, not even in the daytime. Especially in the night time, you might be killed. In all the center.
You said that your sister almost got raped?
Yes.
Do you know anyone else who's been...
Yes, I'm... When you have a problem with them, you go to the police and the police tell to you, I mean, they are refugees, we can't do anything about that. I mean, you have to accept that. I mean, they are dangerous, but they live with it. And so she now is on court and she will, you know, she should.
Has it always been like this in Athens?
No. The situation changed for about a year, from January of 2015. Every day is getting worse and worse.
You feel safe?
Oh, no.
When I come back home from work, I'm a little frightened.
Yeah,
to be honest.
Usually I try to get back home. It's not the best place to be at night. The years it's become worse.
Have you experienced any kind of violence or something in the night here, or have you seen something?
About a week ago, there was a guy fighting with one of the immigrants. They were hitting each other in the face, punching each other. That's about it.
Yeah. And how long have you been living in this area?
All our lives.
All our lives.
Yeah.
It used to be calmer.
It used to be better. Yeah.
It used to be better.
Yeah.
Do you think that it will continue to be bad?
And
how do you feel about that?
We don't know what to do, really.
Okay.
How do you live in an area like this?
So it's well known that Victoria Station
is? Yeah.
It's not just Victoria Station, but one of the places.
How many places is it like this that are over?
It's Omonia Square, which is really bad. I think it might be worse than this. Last time we just walked in the morning and it was really bad.
Mostly the center of Athens.
Yeah, the center. Not so much the suburbs.
That is square, Omonia Square?
Yeah,
Omonia Square. Yeah.
Have you heard or have you seen anything on that square that happened? Or you know anyone who's been
there? There is a lot of drug trafficking going on. I mean, you can just walk there and you just see.
Yeah, not only
it's
there,
the
it's
same
so,
here. Yeah.
Yeah, it's also down from my house. There are always some drug people.
I see gangs moving around in the streets.
Yeah.
And
at what?
They are not Greek. They are not.
Migrants or
migrants
from the Middle East and Africa.
Yeah.
And
probably. Yeah.
Många greker vet av egen erfarenhet att polisen inte kommer att hjälpa dem och känner sig försvarslösa.
And I really want this situation to change one day. I mean, people to realize that, you know, as long as we accept them, one day we will have to live with them forever. I mean, that will be tragic. I mean, it will be the destruction of Europe.